Good morning, Manhasset. I'm Jack Chambers.
And I'm Nithya Wanchu. Please rise for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
This Wednesday, February 1st, is the beginning of Black History Month. This month is meant to honor remarkable African-American figures in history and to celebrate their contributions to society. It also serves as a reminder to continue fighting for justice and equality in our own communities. We at NBC hope that everyone takes a little time to learn how you can celebrate Black History Month.
The middle school play this year is Tuck Everlasting. Let's go check out what's going on in preparation for an amazing performance.
This weekend is the premiere of the middle school production of Tuck Everlasting. Join us in the Black Box Theater on February 3rd and 4th at 7:30 and the 5th at 2 p.m. to watch our amazing Manhasset actors perform. We interviewed the director, Victoria DiCarlo, to hear more about the play.
The middle school play is this weekend, and it is Tuck Everlasting. And Tuck Everlasting is a story about a family who can live forever and a little girl who comes across them and learns their secret and then now is faced with the choice of whether or not she wants to live forever or live a normal life. We built a forest, which is cool. I think it's visually really cool. There's a little bit of magic in there. And the cast comes in December, and they learn all of their scenes and their blocking and the emotional journey of the story. And we've been working pretty consistently since then. The other half of our team, which is the crew, who during the time that the cast is working on their lines and everything, they're working on building the sets and painting and putting together lights and sound effects and the creative aspects of it alongside the acting. There's actually a lot of high schoolers involved in the middle school show, which is really, really cool. They come in and they help teach the middle schoolers who haven't done certain things before and kind of oversee and always lend their assistance, which is really awesome. I hope that people see this show and it makes them think about their own lives and how to live it in the best way that they can.
Tickets are $6 each and can be bought on the Manhasset website or if you scan this QR code. We are looking so forward to seeing this play and supporting the Manhasset theater community. Back to the studio.
Thanks, Luca. Groundhog's Day was yesterday, February 2nd, and Punxsutawney Phil from Pennsylvania just reported that he saw his own shadow. You better keep those winter coats on for a little while longer because we've got 6 more weeks of winter.
It's second semester. You know what that means? It's senioritis season. Now on to Megan Amato, giving us an in-depth look into the disease knocking out the class of 2023.
Senioritis.
Every year around second semester, a strange plague seems to spread through the halls of Manhasset High School, senioritis. This disease takes the senior class by storm, and symptoms may include laziness, sleeping during class, sarcasm, and being the bane of many teachers' existence. Let's see what people had to say about this fascinating phenomenon.
When seniors start doing a little less work and get a bit more lazy.
It's when seniors just don't go to school, basically, and they just stop caring about classes.
It's when a senior jock, like Nacer, you know, wants to not go to school, skip class.
I feel pretty lazy, and I don't want to do anything.
I don't really do school anymore. I literally just went to Disney.
Feels great, to be honest.
Yeah.
We don't have to worry about anything.
Yeah, just chill out, basically.
It's freeing. So freeing.
It feels nice, you know, a lot less stress.
It's great. I got into college. That's when it's like, does it matter anymore?
I had a big time.
Skipping classes.
I've had it ever since first semester.
Yeah.
I mean, obviously, senioritis has been an issue.
Symptoms will come as soon as midterms are over.
Seniors have to start realizing that education is an ongoing process. It doesn't stop.
Common symptoms of senioritis.
Well, head on your desk.
There's not a lot of work that gets done.
The first one is absenteeism.
The most common symptom of senioritis, though, is Wednesday, which is Best Walk Wednesday. There is no sleigh, only recovery.
The worst case of senioritis, well, I once had a student who literally slept through every single first period class.
Well, I've seen cases of senioritis that has caused colleges to reject prior admission for students.
I still have senioritis.
NBC wants everyone to stay safe and be on the lookout for senioritis. Back to you guys in the studio.
That's all for today. I'm Jack Chambers.
And I'm Nithya Wanchu. Stay classy, Manhasset.